All right, Q Fitness, welcome to your Bodyweight low impact workout. We got a 25 minute workout today. Bodyweight means no weight needed, all you need is you and maybe a mat, a nice clear space, right? Make sure you're not going to trip on anything. And low impact does not mean low intensity, but it means no jumping, okay? So if you're on the second floor, if you got kids around that you don't want to wake up, maybe they're taking a nap, this is the workout for you. It's going to be 25 minutes of moderate to a high intensity, depending on how hard you make it. Okay, get you warmed up. Bear hugs. Arms are scissoring side to side, stretching your chest and your back as you do this one. Arm circles your neck, start slow, start small. Gradually get bigger.
Send it.
And then go the other way. Good posture, chest up, abs in. Some shoulder shrugs your neck, up, back, and down. Loosening up the shoulders. Neck is neck, ear to ear. Side to side, some rotations. Trunk rotations are next. Hands on your hips, feet wider than your hips, three times each way. And then reverse directions, forward, left, back, right. Feet together right next to each other. Circle your knees a few times, other way. And then ankle rolls. Other side. All right. Drop down, we're gonna do 5 push-ups and then 5 squats. A little bit of strength stuff for your warm-up here. Big inhale at the top, exhale as you push up. Right up onto your feet, reverse lunge. Reach over top, stretch the whole side of your body, hold it for a few seconds. You can use 2 hands if you'd like. After you do a few on each side, keep 1 foot back and just stretch out your calf. Drop that back heel to the ground, stretch the calf. Hold it for maybe 5 to 10 seconds. And then switch sides. Goal here is to get that heel on the ground. So you stretch the Achilles tendon, plantar fascia, gastrocnemius, soleus, all those muscles that help to stabilize and the ankle and propel us forward for movement. All right, a few more neck rolls, maybe a few wrist rolls, and then we'll get you going. So we got 30 seconds of the plank and then 30 seconds of the squat. We'll go in 10 seconds. So your plank, you're gonna be on your elbows. Starting in 3, 2, 1, go. This is just a static move, right? Static strength, so abdominals in, zip your ribcage down towards your hips. Trying to strengthen the spinal erectors of your back so your hips don't collapse, as well as your rectus abdominis, your obliques, your lats, obliques. Static strength, this is a good exercise. Up on your feet, nice job, squat the neck. Palms up. Sit your hips down and back. Keep that chest lifted. Eyes straight ahead. Ready. Go. The squat. You go slow at first, it'll help to engage some more muscles with the hips. Test the knees out wide. Keep the eyes straight ahead, like I said, chest up. You feel your glutes working, your hamstrings, your quads, or your hips, the back of your legs, the front of your legs. And then your posture maybe too. All the erectors of your back. Nice job, back to that plank. If you want to ramp up the plank, you could also do a mountain climber. Mountain climbers look like this. Keep your shoulders right above your wrists. Stabilize your core by drawing in your belly and alternate legs. Either one's good. I'm gonna hold the plank today. If you want more intensity, maybe you're doing that mountain climber. As you exhale, feel a stronger contraction through your abdominals. Keep your head up in line with your shoulders and hips. Try to draw your belly button in, create a nice small waist. Back up on your feet, back to a squat. Now if you want more out of the squat, you can do a knee. So you're gonna squat down. As you come up, bring a knee to the opposite elbow. Sit back on the heels. Keep the chest up. Nice upright posture as you squat. Back to the plank. Nice job. Take a couple of breaths to catch your breath. And drop back down. Good. This could be called PHA, peripheral heart action, where you're working the upper body, doing the plank, stabilizing at your shoulders and lats, and then working your lower body, doing the squat. It's great for fat loss, it's great for muscle building. Nice job, back up on your feet. Third set of squats, your choice. You need to do the squat or the squat with the knee, right? Your choice. Chest up, abs zipped in. Sit back on the heels. Go. Doing great, Q Fitness. So glad you made it today. Welcome to the workout of the week. Thanks for checking out Donna's emails if you're on the email list. Great little perk that you have here. Working for Qualcomm or Spouse Up. Nice job. One last set. Back to the plank. Or the mountain climber, your choice. If you want more out of that mountain climber, you could also do a tricep plank. Tricep planks look like this. Lift up onto your hands. Drop back down. Either one's good. The second one's gonna put more emphasis on those triceps, right? Or if you're doing that mountain climber, you're also getting more tricep work because you're just holding yourself up off the ground. Triceps are really a endurance muscle. Nice job, one last set of squats. Back on the heels. Keep your eyes up. Open up the knees. Open up the chest. A couple more. Time, nice job. You got a minute break before we move on to the next combo. Take a 1 minute break, get some water if you got it. You need to stretch, please feel free to stretch a little bit. The same thing with next combo is just gonna be your body weight. So what we're doing is push-up or a kick through. I'll show you both. We're going to combine that with a lunge. All right. We're going about 10 seconds. So the T push-up start out in the push-up position, lower down, as you push yourself up, you rotate an arm up in the air. Looks like this. Alternate sides. You need to modify it. Go to your knees. So yeah, you're getting some rotation here, right? So you're working your obliques. You're working the stability of your shoulders. Next one's just a lunge, just a forward lunge, real simple. Okay. So you go hands on your hips, chest lifted up, abdominals in, up in the knees, here we go, alternate legs. You want more, you can go hands up. You're pushing hard off of that front foot to get yourself back to upright. Sometimes you're carrying someone on your back as you work your legs, quads, calves, hamstrings, glutes. Down one, done, three sets to go. That T push-up, modified T push-up from your knee if you need to, or this time a kick through. So hold the push-up position, kick a leg through, okay? Takes a lot more balance and stability. Alternate sides, 30 seconds. Trying to keep your shoulder right above your wrist. Okay, this is just a progression from that first one. T push-up. Back to the lunge, nice job. Couple of breaths, nice and tall. Chest up, abs in. Ooh. If you need to modify this, you could just do a stationary lunge. Up and down, right? If you do five on the left, make sure you do five on the right. Or you could just stick with that forward lunge. Or maybe that forward lunge bothers your knees. You could do backward lunges. Good job, back to that Brazilian, or excuse me, that kick through. Kick through or the T push-up. We're just alternating between these two exercises. T push-up looks like this. Kick through looks like this. Your choice. Keep going. Nice job. Back to those lunges. Or if you need to modify, you can do a stationary lunge. Or if you want more, you could do your 3-point get up. 3 points on the ground, right? Hand, front foot, back foot to a high knee. Do about 10, you can switch legs. Or you could just stick with that forward lunge like we did before. One last round, same stuff. Doing good, Q Fitness, keep it up. One more set of each, just one more minute of work, then you get a minute of break. Push-ups or kick-throughs, your choice. Now, if these bother your wrist, you could also just hold that plank again, or you could do a side plank. It's also good. Work back to the lunge.
One last set.
Should be breathing a little bit heavier about now. Maybe sweating a little bit. Lunges, go. Or you want more, that 3-point get up is good too. Or maybe you just speed up this lunge. Big arm movement. Like you're sprinting.
Nice job in a break. Get some water.
We got one more combo. And you're all done. Nice job, Q Fitness. Let's see. How far along are we here? Doing good. Yeah. We're 15 minutes into the workout. We got about 6 more minutes, and we'll do a 2-minute cool down. Just about 25 minutes. Good stuff. Again, feel free to stretch if you need to. So the next two are upper body and then lower body again, so you can call it PHA, peripheral heart action. Here we go, down dog to plank. Start out on the down dog. Lower down into the plank. Alternate these two. Breathe out here. Breathe in here. Try to improve your nasal breathing. Breathe through your nose. Nice job. Your next one's the bridge, so just lie on your back. Squeeze your glutes, draw your abdominals in. Lift through your chest. Squeeze your glutes, lift your hips. Run back to that down dog to plank. If you want more on this one, you can also do the inchworm. So your down dog to plank is this one, right? The one that we just did. You're holding the down dog and then you're breathing in on the plank. If you want more, you can walk your hands in.
Stand up.
Walk your hands out. Inchworms.
I'm the party starter.
I'm gonna stick with the down dog to plank today. Again, if your wrists bother you, you could also just do that plank on your elbows. Nice job. Your next one's the bridge, so you can lie on your back again. Use your glutes, lift your chest, throw the belly in, lift the hips. Right. This is your level one, level two. You got your crab, hips up, hips down.
I'm the party starter. Do you feel the flow?
This is a good shoulder opener as well as hip extension, so you're trying to extend the hips all the way up. Good job. Back to that down dog to plank. Go down the plank this time. Big inhale. Exhale and lift.
Everybody, let's go.
So what are you working here? Arms, right? Biceps, triceps. Take over the long head of the bicep. Just keep your arms straight. Last, stabilizing your shoulders. Your rotator cuff. Shoulders as you push, maybe a little bit of deltoids and upper chest. Trying to use those lats up. Nice job. Back to the bridge. Big inhale. Exhale and lift. Or you could do it the other way. Inhale and lift. Exhale and decrease and lower. Trying to get that full hip extension here. If you want more, you can march your legs, right? Or you can do that crab. Back to that down dog. There you go, hold your plank. Exhale and lift. I'm on your back. Bridge again, or marching bridge. Marching bridges could be tough. You could also do a single leg bridge. Chest up, shoulders down your back. Big inhale, lift. As you're doing the marching bridge, try to keep your hips level. Hopefully, of all three of these exercises, you found one that you like and you're sticking to. Do the bridge, the marching bridge, or the crab. Nice job. 1 minute break. Grab some water. There you go. Again, stretch anything that feels stiff or tight. Doing great. Nice job. All right, so we're just gonna stretch out your quadriceps. We got two stretches before you head out. Quadriceps and triceps. Should feel pretty good. Standing up tall, trying to keep your knees pretty close together. Lifting through the chest, drawing the belly in. Head back. Get nice and tall. Switch legs. Now the quadriceps, right? There's four muscles across the front of your thigh or the front of your upper leg down to the top of your lower leg. Rectus femoris attaches right on the top of the hips, comes right down to the top of the knee. You have your vastus lateralis on the outside, vastus medialis on the inside, vastus intermediate on the middle and vastus medialis on the inside. Grab your tricep, grab your elbow, stretch your tricep to the back of your arm. Take a couple of deep breaths. Switch arms. Feel a nice stretch across the back of the arm, maybe down through the side of your body. Take a big inhale, circle your arms, reach up in the air. Exhale and fold. Your body weight low impact workout with Brian. Thanks for coming to the workout of the week, guys. So glad you made it. Have a great day.